Live in HD from the station that brings you more West Texas news. News West 9 at 10 starts now.
5199, we need the ambulances on the south side of the railroad tracks. Get as many as we can.
Tonight, we're hearing the voices of emergency responders from the first moments following the accident involving a train crashing into a parade float carrying war veterans and their spouses.
NewsWest 9 obtained their radio communications, and it's clear right from the start they wasted no time calling in as much help as they could get. Josh Navarro joins us with the story. Josh.
Crystal, Mike, what you're about to hear may sound like scenes out of a movie, but in this case, it's all reality as emergency responders saw this entire tragedy unfold right in front of their eyes.
Guys, this trailer got hit by a train. We need EMS units as you can.
It's 3:43 dispatch. It's going to be an 18-wheeler with several passengers on board.
You're hearing it play-by-play via radio communications.
We need to start blocking off Front Street and Garfield at this intersection. Go back about 4 or 5 blocks either direction.
Emergency crews on scene of the train crash site last Thursday, where over a dozen people were injured and the end result killing 4 veterans.
Ambulances on the south side of the railroad tracks. Get as many as we can.
You can hear the sounds of the railroad crossing alarm signals in the background, as well as the cry for help from people.
Call code 1000. You got at least 12 injuries here. We need every available ambulance we can get.
All hands were on deck that day, from law enforcement to Medical Memorial Hospital, where almost all of the victims were rushed to.
We have John Hamilton at the ED at the hospital. He's going to get everything set to start receiving patients as they come in.
Now, the recordings are about 9 minutes long, and you can hear it on its entirety on NewsWest9.com later tonight. Josh Navarro, NewsWest 9.